In this vlog, I'm gonna show you how I paint helmets. I'm sitting here in my paint box, and here on my table, I have two new helmets from Schubert, carbon helmets, with for Maxime Martin, the Aston Martin factory driver who also drove BMW DTM the last 2 years. His helmet is there, and I'm gonna show you step by step how I do it. It's a long process, so I guess this video is gonna be long, but I will try to show you everything I do and how I do it. The first thing I'm gonna show you is the design. This I got from Maxime. As you can see, it's black, white and green, a little bit red. I'm gonna paint also the logos, but not the Hackett logo. This is gonna put on sticker later on. It's not really complicated, but it's complicated enough. And when you see the designer, you can guess which color I'm gonna start paint. Wrong answer. I'm gonna paint the green one. And this green color is a flashy green light color, and the helmets are black. So before I paint the green, I have to paint the helmets white. I need white in the bottom from the green one. If not, the green one gonna be dark and not nice at all. And when the green is painted, then we're gonna mask up these green lines, also this Maxime green, and cover it. And then we're gonna cover either the black or the white and paint one of this color. And when that's done, we do the opposite of the black and the white, and then the shadow. It's a long process. I will show you later. I will show you step by step. Just follow. Here we have the two helmets. As you can see, it's completely stripped down. It's under the shell, which is coming from Schubert. So when I'm done, it's gonna be sent back to Schubert and they're gonna mount it. First thing we're gonna do now is sand it down with this one and this one. They are done sanded, and now I clean both of them with a special clean. The helmets are ready and I have white color in my gun, so let's start. White, now I'm gonna paint them green. Here we have the bottom color done painted. Now I used a tool I made many years ago. Here I can spin the helmet around. I can adjust this one up and down. I have a pencil inside here. I can go adjust in and out like that. Here you can see now I made a line. Here I'm gonna put the tape later. We're gonna mask the green line we're gonna use. This is gonna do on both helmets now. Same time I'm watching the Formula One race from Australia Grand Prix. All the lines are now drawn on. Now we can see I've been using this 3mm fine line. I taped on the lines. I'm working on this helmet now. And the reason why I put those on, extra masking, is because this this type, it's a little bit, I'm stretching it a little bit when I put it on. So the corners like this was really sharp. If I don't put this one over, it will stretch in and yeah, get loose and get a little bit shorter, take the shorter way over there. That's why I use this one to keep it where it should be. So the next one out, next thing now, is to mask this mux there. And this we have to make at my plotter. You can see here on the computer to the plotter, I made now the mux. Now we're gonna push cutter. And this Roland plotter, we cut it out in this folie. You can see here now on the type, the plotter have cut it out. Now I'm gonna move this mux over to the helmet. There we go. So, Max is on both sides, on both helmets. Now I'm gonna paint the white. And then I have to mask everything which is going to be black later. No, I'm gonna paint the black. So I'm gonna mask everything which is going to be white later. Then I use this normal masking type. And here, I cut out like this. There we go. One done masked. And the second one is masked. Before I start to paint black now, I have to check all the blue tape that it's still where it should be here in the corners. Make sure it's tight. Also this one, you can see I can push it a little bit more. We have a little air between there. That's not good because then the paint is coming underneath there. A little bit dust, and that's not looking good. Then we have to repair it later on. That's a lot of work. And here at the M there, I have to use the heat gun a little bit to stretch the sticker underneath. And do like this. Make sure to stretch it. Black color is done mixed. And as you can see, we don't need too much paint. And we're gonna use this Sata Pistola. Here we go. done painted black, both of them. And this color I've been painting now is a base color. It's 5 minutes and I painted this one and it's completely dry. This and all the other colors is base colors, drying really fast, but they need clear coat on top of them to make it hard and glossy, because this is also completely matte, as you can see. You can also wash this away with some strong cleaning now. This paint is not so strong. But the clear coat we're gonna put when all the colors, logos and everything is done. And the clear coat gonna dry for a day. Then I'm gonna sand it down and paint clear coat again. Because every time you paint, it's really important to think about paint as less color as possible. Because you're painting against the tape I put on. And when you put too much paint, you get a big edge there. But if you put too much, it's not so nice. It's always gonna be an edge there anyway, but less as possible. This is also because we have to put clear coat 2 times, but this I will show you the process of later on. Now, I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna do next. We're gonna paint this logo, we're gonna make these shadows, we're gonna make the white line there, and we're gonna paint this Coyote logo there on the top. We're gonna make this white line there, the shadow there. I think maybe we're gonna make the shadow on this one. Also here on the green there. So it's gonna be called DW down there. Now I'm gonna measure how big we're gonna have logo, and I think we're gonna have it 8 centimeters. So let me write it there, it's gonna be 880. Now it's coming a little bit difficult thing. You see this logo, this Coyote? This is gonna have here. But if I make this logo straight as a normal logo, since the helmet is chrome this way and this way, the logo gonna look like a banana. It's not gonna follow this line, you see? So now I have to measure out how much it is, and I have to make the logo like a banana so it's gonna fit perfectly. I have all the measurement I need, so let's go into my workshop and make some logos. And my workshop is my racing trailer. Straight here. Here we have my sails. This is gonna be finished in a few weeks. We're going testing. And the plotter I'm having here. Now I can see I put the logos up here. I also made this one a little bit like a banana. You can see here now, I moved the letters inside. This is opposite of what you do with normal when you make normal stickers. And now we're gonna move this over to the helmet. Folio, just put it on the top there. Then we cut it out. Here we go. Now I have it. We're gonna mount it here. And now we carefully remove this one. And since the helmet is so chrome all the ways, it's difficult to fit it to some places like this. We have to sheet a little bit, we have to cut it, then put it down. That was one. Only all the other logos left. This is my wife. Both helmet is now completely covered with masking tape, and now we're gonna paint white in the logo. This logo is gonna be green and also gonna be a little bit red. The part of the logo we're gonna stay white is not covered. I'm gonna use this small gun when I paint the green one. The color is inside. So then we just start. Now I do the same with the logo here on the front. We have to be red. Take off some of this masking. But one thing, when I'm taking off the masking like I'm doing now, it's really important to see that if I don't bring some of the masking, we're not supposed to go off now. Like when I take this one, it can be quickly and easy to bring this line with mask there, and this we are not gonna take off now. Yeah, actually like I did here now. Now I took this one with me. This should still be covered. So that was not so good. Now I have to try to put it slowly back there. There we go. Not too bad. So here comes the Coyote logo also. I'm gonna take off this mask there, who we masked earlier on, but this sticker is going underneath here and into the other colors. So I have to cut here now first. Like that. That's in the, just on the middle of the blue line I made. Now we're gonna take off this one. Now I put this 1.5 millimeter fine line
completely next to the blue one I put earlier on, as you can see. Both is now masked for painting this shadow.
Let's give it a try. And now I'm gonna take off this one. Come on.
There you have your shadow. This small shadow.
And now I put the first blue one up there. Now I'm gonna do like this, because then I know how far it's gonna be. So it's gonna be the same on all the helmets, or both of them.
And it's totally masked.
So we paint white inside it.
Like that. I'm now done making the white shadow there on the front here. I made the white shadow there. I made this one. I made these two shadows, and I made a shadow down there. This I did on both helmets. Now I'm gonna make some black shadow on this green. Black shadow I'm talking about is the one who is there. That's gonna make a 3D effect. I'm done with the black shadows, as you can see there. Next step is to paint the white. The white places now is now covered with masking. This we're gonna take off, or I'm gonna take it off. Then we're gonna mask the black who is done. Then we're gonna paint the white and make the white finish. The black is done masked, but now before I paint white, I'm gonna use this viskler, I don't know what the name is in English, and remove all the lines I made in the beginning.
Then we are one step closer to finish.